Now the channel shows up and the sneak attack. So whoever got Edric, or not Edric, Emrakul on accident might have incentive to kind of go deep here. Whereas I am stuck not taking Boreal Druid because I think I want to play mostly islands. Maybe just taking Scalding Tarn and hoping to spike a green-blue land. That's reasonable. I mean, I'm not going to play Titan. Cortisar, unfortunately, is not great. Simic Skyswallow is a bit expensive for my tastes. I actually do want low-drop creatures. Low-drop blue creatures are what I want. So let's just take the Tarn. Jeez, and the Gristlebrand. Someone's going to have a nice deck. I'm just going to take Miscalculation because it's a cheap interactive spell, which is really what I'm looking for here. I'm surprised they have Exploration in this cube. Exploration is not a very good card. Ooh, Trade and Rider. This is a nice Trade and Rider deck, too, so I think I'm going to take that. I mean, I like Mox Diamond. I think it's a reasonable card, but I think this deck would rather just have the Trade and Rider. Too bad I can't take Huntmaster, because Huntmaster plus Aether Vial is a pretty sweet little combo. Vial it in, it doesn't count as playing a spell. Flip it immediately. It's also not a Gilded Lotus deck, and Trade and Rider fits the theme. All right, I need some cheap creatures. I need 1, 2, and 3 drops. That's all I'm looking for now. Well, I've got a 3-drop. I mean, a 3-drop counterspell is still a card I can play before turn 3. I'm afraid, even though I like Dungeon Geists, I am getting pretty heavy on 4s, so I think at this point I might want to just take Hinder just so I have relevant spells to play in the early game. Alright, now I can take Enclave Cryptologist. That helps, I don't know, with a ninja. It helps with Trade and Rider and Opposition, at the very least. And there's nothing else here I want, even if I was heavier green. I think one thing to consider is that maybe I need to play cheap green cards to round out my creature count, but if I can pick up a couple more blue creatures, then I just won't have to do that. Alright, there's two actually pretty good options here. One is Deep Analysis, because, you know, I like casting card draw spells. The other is actually Stomping Ground, because Stomping Ground means that Misty Rainforest, or more importantly, Scalding Tarn, now fixes both green and blue mana. It could also, and also if I wanted to splash red, now I've got a Bloodstained Mire 2. Yeah, I think I actually do want to take the Stomping Ground just to make so my mana is that much better. Alright, this is not a creature, but Essence Scatter is something I can cast early and does a relevant thing. I like Smokestack too with Opposition and Master of Waves, but I think I need a 2-drop a lot more than I need a 4-drop. Ooh, Compulsive Research. I like that card too. I mean, just because I'm playing sweet cards or creatures doesn't mean I can't cast Compulsive Research. I don't love Halimar Depths, so I'm going to pass on that. Alright, Call the Herd actually might be a card I want. Just because, again, it's a 3-drop creature. There's also Simic Skyswallower as a big finisher. Let's see. So I'm going to have enough playables regardless. The question is, do I want a 3-drop or more? I think I actually just want the 3-drop. I think that's more reasonable here. All right, so I'm not playing Bloodstained Mire. And this is 23 cards for 17 land. Seems pretty reasonable to me. And, alright, now we're in the not playing any of these cards column. I guess I could take Thornscape to play the Stomping Ground to maybe cast it for red-green. Or Ravenous Baboons. No, I'm just going to hate the Iona, I guess. Alright, Sacred Foundry. Does that do anything for me? If I'd taken the Thornscape, it might. And Mountain Valley does get just red-green, so that doesn't do anything. I guess Earthquake's a card I could potentially side in. Alright, Vengevine is at least a strong card, so maybe I can get an opportunity to play that. Ooh, I can Academy Ruins back my Aether Vial. Well, let's just take the Graver over there. Alright, I think I actually kind of got there on the mono blue deck. I mean, I'm playing mono blue for plus 3 green cards. I can play like 2 or 3 forests, if even that, honestly. And I think this deck ended up like a nice little like tempo opposition type deck. Ooh, let's not play against Pristine Angel. Torch Fiend can kill Vial. Again, I'm not too worried about that. And Carnifage as usual. I'm literally playing every blue card I have. Like, that's not even a joke. And other than that, I think I'm in good shape. I have 12 creatures only, but Call of Herd counts one, so it's 13. And then Legacy's Lord kind of counts, so it's 14. And then I've also got, you know, a card draw spell, and a Mold Drifter is also a card draw spell. So I think we're actually doing fine here. And I think Curse Catcher and Enclave Cryptologist justify themselves because of Opposition and Trade and Rider. Both those use creatures fairly well, plus Master Waves likes them. As for mana, I have these things, and I'm not going to play the Bloodstained Mire. I think Civic Growth Chamber is actually okay. It's a good combo with Compulsive Research. I can play, like, yeah, one drop into Civic Growth Chamber is not horrible. I don't know. I feel like this is actually going to be decent. And I'm not playing a Swamp for my Night Vale Spectre. So how many green sources do I need? I only have 3 green cards. They're obviously all single green. Apparently that's still that. Alright, so 3 green cards, or single green, they cost 3. 3 and 4, and Call of Herd's the only one that really wants to be played turn 3. Edric, I think. Another card that justifies Curse Catcher, by the way. Could be played a little bit later. Plus, I can Vial out Edric and Mystic Snake. So, given that, right now I've got 1, 2, 3, 4. So, 4 should be 5. If I can go 6, 10, 2, this will have 10, I'll have 14 blue sources. My main concern here is Night Vale Spectre and then Teferi. And I also have, you know, double blue 2 drops like Legacy's Allure and whatnot. So, this should be enough. Because 6 green sources plus an Aether Vial should be enough for those things. So, alright. Yeah, this deck looks awesome. I'm very excited to play this deck.